Hey, hey. How are you all? We're going to get some facts straight. Okay, let's go and be the nosy people of the internet, stalk the internet, and get some facts straight for once. You probably also heard it. I've heard it. I get this thrown at me all the fucking time. Oh, but pro fucking anti-Linux man, Windows user, proprietary code lover, Linux is 90% of the server market. Is it really? Not to speak, that's going a little bit sidetrack here. Even if it was 100% of all servers running Linux, that don't mean that it's a good desktop operating system. There is a reason why Windows and other operating systems have enterprise versions and desktop versions, because what's good for the server is not good for the desktop. Can a desktop become a server and can a server become a desktop? Yep. But for the industry, what they need is really different from what you need. So saying that, oh, but Linux is 90% of the server market, it's not a good argument why it's better as a desktop. Let's go into what this video is about. Is Linux really 90% of the server market? And you know what? I did some amazing things that all of you guys and girls out there should be doing when you're using stuff like that as a fact to say that I'm a stupid motherfucker. I am, but at least have the facts straight, okay? Have the facts straight. If you want to come at me and other people and yell at them, have your facts straight. So I did some fact-checking for you guys and girls out there. Didn't take long, but I did it for you. So let's see what the actual numbers are for Linux on the server market. This is a site. It's a website that do statistics. Or have at least done statistics here. And I've looked at 5 to 10 different websites, and this is the numbers that they all come up with. So this must be somewhat accurate. If every website that I look at that tracks server statistics for Linux and other servers or other operating systems on the server market is coming up with like almost identical numbers, that means that this must be accurate. Linux is 90% of the server market. Yes, 90% of the top 1 million or whatever the fuck it is, web servers, not file servers, not domain servers, not DNS servers, not you name it, web servers. And even with that, they are not even 90%. It's only of the top 1 million or whatever popular web servers. If we go down here, top 1,000, they are about 50%. Top 10,000, about 50%. Top 100,000, about 50%. Top 1 million, 45%. I'm rounding up and down. Overall, so for all of the web servers, down to the single one web server that you can find in your mom's basement, up till the number one web server, if you take all of that with not the top this and top that, Linux is only 40%. And I'm really rounding up. I should actually say 39. But I'm nice to you Linux people out there. So I would say 40% of the overall server market. Not 90. When I say server, I mean web server. Again, we're not talking file servers, DNS servers, you know, domain servers, account servers, share servers, virtual machine servers, you name it. Only web servers. Web servers. You have to remember this, web servers. Because if you go and say the overall web server market, Linux is not that widely used. Linux is massive on the web servers. That's why I use this as an example, because it's probably the place that they are used the most on web servers. So to, again, help you pamper, you know, inflate your ego a little bit, I'm actually using the best case scenario to make Linux look the best it can possible. And it's still not looking that great, because overall, it's not the most used web server operating system. Here, this is what I want to, I couldn't remember it. So server market share worldwide by operating system. Now we're talking global. All servers, main servers, web servers, blah, 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 blah. Not just web servers, virtual machine servers and stuff like that. Server market share worldwide per operating system. We're taking all servers within it. What is the most used operating system if we are counting all servers into the equation? Windows. OS 3.9. 990, I think that's a Unix system, is 2.1. We have Unix with 5.6. We have Other with 6.5. We have Linux with 13.6. And I know a lot of you amazing, raging Linux fanboys out there that want to fucking cut my balls off. It's like, well, Other is Linux because Linux is sometimes hard to detect. So is Windows. It depends on how, you know, the servers are set up and stuff, that the website cannot ping them easily, the website or the statistic gathering sites that are taking these statistics. Even if you put the 6.5% into the Linux fucking category, it's still dwarfed by Windows on the server market. In the overall server market, not web servers, but every form of server that is. So I'm a nice guy. I'm trying to make Linux look the best it can. I will give you those 6.5%. You are still being dwarfed by fucking Windows. Again, research you can do if you apply yourself 5 minutes on the internet. I love these things, fanboys. Actually, I don't. They drive me up the walls and make me want to clue my balls to my testicles to the desk and then slam my head into them. But anyway, this is a really interesting statistics. Let's look at the use case for Linux on web servers. Remember, Linux was prominent or the most used web server operating system out there. So if we look into it here, actually, Unix is the most used web server operating system by far, if you look at this statistic here. And you can see here, Ubuntu is actually the most used web server operating system. Web server, because remember, Linux is not 90% of the server market. It's actually really, really low. If we are taking the overall server market, it's 13% or 14%. And even more, if you take the 6.5% in there, Windows is still still dwarfing Linux on the overall server market, but Linux is dwarfing Windows, or almost dwarfing Windows, or at least competing with Windows in the web server market. But what is the statistic saying about Linux on the web server market? This is from the last year. The higher up this is, the more market share. If you look from November 21 to November now, it's slowly declining. Let that sink in. It's slowly declined. Am I saying this is going to be like this forever? No. But for the last year, on the server market that Linux is really strong at, it's actually declining slowly. What is it declining to? Windows, Mac, Unix, FreeBSD. I have no fucking idea. That's not the point of this video. I haven't researched that, but it's slowly declining. Does this mean we are talking probably a couple of percent? Next year it may be up again. Again, like I said, this is not an indication that Linux on the server market is going, or on the web server market, sorry, is going to hit the fucking rock bottom in 2 or 5 years. This is just what happened the last year. Is this a trend that we could? I don't think it is, because Linux has always been massively strong as a web server. I don't think this is a trend that we should be like, oh, be nervous about. I'm just showing you data that you can find on the internet. And this is the market position and stuff like that. So what you should take away with this video is Linux is not 90% of the server market. It's not even the fucking dominant operating system in the server market. It's one of the bigger ones on web servers, not the overall server market, web servers. If you look at the overall server market, it's kind of what macOS is on the desktop compared to Windows. It's not small, but it's not the best. It's not 90%. Oh, well, not the best. I don't know which one is the best. That's a debate for another time. But it's definitely not 90%, as a lot of the fucking amazing Linux nerds out there are saying. That though Linux is 90% of the server market, apparently not, it's only 13.6. Let's give you the 6% and say it's like 20 or 21% compared to 72 on all servers. But again, web servers, it has a little bit more market share. So think about this, my lovely Linux nerds out there. I know I'm a little bit harsh towards you guys lately, but it drives me up the walls that even the core Linux users don't understand facts about the operating system that they fucking like. See you all later. Have an amazing day. Bye bye.